You mentioned the Inbetweeners. They're obviously hugely successful independent films. I'm curious, does the immense financial success of the films make it hard to resist the pressure or the temptation to do a third?
I think we're not going to do a third. I think it was an amazing journey that we went on, and we never expected it to get that far. I think we're all now ready to call it a day on that front. I think we've just run out of stories and anecdotes from that time of our lives. It was amazing. We were so grateful that we got to go along that far. And I mean, it seems surreal almost that we got to do it for that long. But I think it would be, I think it's extremely unlikely that we do something now. I think it was a great thing that happened and went along for a long time, but I think it's time to call it a day.
How do you feel about how you left The Boys? Because I think the first film felt like it was a triumphant goodbye, and the second film felt more like it was kind of a, oh no, we want them to suffer, we want to leave them on a low point.
I think it was a bit like saying you can't behave like that actually in adult life, to be honest. It was like, there will come a point where you can't be forgiven for this sort of behaviour. And I think they did want to put them in a bit of jeopardy, I think, and actually say, like, this is, you know, you'll get out of your depth if you carry on like this forever. So, in a way, it leads back to your former question, I think, which is that those characters had to grow up at some point, and actually, you can be, I would say, total idiot when you're a teenage boy, and probably everything will be okay, but you can't really carry on with that into your 20s or even 30s, and I think the probably film was leading towards maybe saying something along those lines. So perhaps that's why it was.